Yeah, I want to stay a little bit on the topic of the squad while just while you've mentioned them right there. You know, obviously there were, you know, some victories, some new additions in the house. I'm wondering what kind of effective resistance and, you know, to extent that there will be any kind of effective resistance possible with the McConnell, you know, stranglehold and an impotent Democratic Party. What would you like to see the squad, how would you like to see them behave in Congress, I should say, in this next upcoming term? What would good resistance look like to you?
Well, actually, good resistance looks like what AOC just did 2 days ago, where she basically called out the entire Democratic establishment. And I am so proud, you know, of Alexandria for what she did. You know, she basically said to them, look, I'm not the enemy. Medicare for All is not the enemy. Black Lives Matter is not the enemy. You know, stop treating the progressive movement and the and your progressive base like the enemy. You know, she used those that strong of words. And she was absolutely right to. Because the corporate Democrats, again, they think that they can just feed the people platitudes, punch left, and then govern for Wall Street. Those days are over. Like, we fine, you did that for the last 50 years. You're going to try to pull that status quo BS now, in this moment, when there's this much inequality? That's not going to fly anymore. So, you know, mad props to what AOC did by, you know, talking out, speaking out to the New York Times and saying and just saying like, yeah, look, we're not the enemies here. That pressure she just put back on the corporatists and her party, that's what they all have to do. You know, I know that Cori Bush, you know, Cori Bush is a fighter. You know, that's the kind of, you know, she's in Congress to fight for the working class and communities of color. You know, I followed her, you know, I supported her campaign. I'm excited that, you know, we, instead of four, we've got six, you know, or maybe seven, if you include Mondaire Jones and Jamal Bowman. So look, that part is great. But again, they need us on the outside pressuring and pressuring these corporatists. And the other thing I'll say is some progressives think that, you know, they want to, you know, kind of join DSA, which again, I support DSA, Democratic Socialists of America, or they want to join Justice Democrats and they want to keep, you know, trying to transform the Democratic Party from the inside. And I support that strategy, but I also support the strategy of building power for our movement on the outside with the Movement for a People's Party, joining Cornel West and Nina Turner and Marianne Williamson and everyone who spoke at the People's Convention and really putting together a party that won't take corporate money and won't be influenced by, you know, these powerful corporations. So then we can just push policies for the people. But what I want to say is whether you want to play the inside game and do DSA and Justice Democrats, or you want to play the outside game and do the Movement for a People's Party, we have to have solidarity among progressives against the corporatists. We can't fight. You know, there's not enough progressives for us, you know, for the ones who want to play the inside game and the ones who want to play the outside game, for us to start going at each other. We have to keep solidarity among our movement, among the progressive movement, whether, you know, and I support both strategies. I think both will give us maximum pressure on the establishment. And again, like, when you've got corporatists who are literally there to serve Wall Street and who've got, you know, people like Nancy Pelosi, who's been there for 3 decades. And, you know, think of all the corporate lobbyists, you know, she's connected to. Think of all the corporate lobbyists Chuck Schumer's connected to. You know, a lot of people don't realize this. When they wrote the Affordable Care Act back in, you know, 2009, 2010, about 4,000 lobbyists descended on Washington to help write that. The Affordable Care Act is a for-profit predatory healthcare system. It was originally a Republican plan. And the ACA represents corporate Democrats to a T. Right now, Chuck Schumer is on television glorifying it and acting like it's the greatest thing ever. They want to act like the ACA is so great when and premiums have gone up every year since it passed. And most people can't afford their premiums anymore. The ACA is not great. What's great is Medicare for All. But the reason these corporate Democrats defend the ACA and are still peddling it is because it's good for their corporate donors. And these Democrats are owned by the giant insurance companies and big pharma. And so, you know, they get us in this like tunnel vision of like, oh yeah, ACA, pre-existing conditions. Well, guess what? Medicare for All protects everyone with pre-existing conditions and at a fraction of the cost, you know? And so we have got to stop accepting the framing from these corporate Democrats. We've got to stop compromising our progressive values. We've got to stop allowing them. I mean, time and time again, these corporatists have stabbed us in the back. And then we act like they're our friends, or we act like, you know, here they are. They just elected Chuck Schumer. They just voted for him to be Senate Majority Leader again. Like, are you kidding me? Or Senate Minority Leader?
Yeah,
are you kidding me? Like, that's not a party that's trying to change and trying to appeal to the working class. We know what Chuck Schumer's done for the last few decades. He's governed for Wall Street. So, and I guarantee you, they'll do the same thing with Speaker Pelosi. She's already trying to be Speaker again. And I'm vehemently opposed to both of them. But again, this is a party that wants to continue to, well, we're not as bad as the Republicans, right? That's their strategy. Vote for us because we're not as bad as them. Well, guess what? That's not good enough when there's this many people suffering. We need to be able to vote for good if we want to have a better nation. And neither of these parties, honestly, is worthy of our votes, because neither of them represents the people's interests.